Imagine banking over 20,000 rand in sales with just 2 days. Well, this is exactly what this gentleman has been able to accomplish. In the past 2 days, he was able to make just over 20,000 rand in sales of selling signals. Yo, what's up you guys? Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to review the signals for SELLO LEDWABA for the month of March. But before we get there, if you are looking for free AI signals that comes with an open TP and SL, you can go check out Fastball. Now, the best thing about this is you can also go back and look at the results for the previous days, previous months, check what the P&L was, what the win rate is, everything. All of this is absolutely free. It doesn't cost a cent. And that's about it. I'll leave a link in the comment section below for you guys to go and check out, right? Now, like I said, this guy banked over 20K in the past two days, right? That's probably less than what a lot of people get paid per month. But this once again shows how successful the signal industry is for people and how some people came here with an expectation, right? Now, let's go through the signals very quickly. Now, on March the 1st, what we can see over here is there was a buy on USD JPY with a TP and an SL. But before we get there, I just want to show you guys the Instagram because there's nothing really new here. It does charge 500 rand for the signals. If you times 251, you're looking at up just over 100k in sales, right? But let's talk about the format of the signals. There's a buy on USD JPY that's got one TP and one stop loss, right? Which is the way we would generally want to see the signals, be sent. Very clear and easy for the, the average consumer to understand. Now, this is what that signal looked like, right? That's the TP and that's the SL. The overall trade is about a 1%. Plus, this was a break-even trade because you can see they put stop loss to break-even and the market unfortunately U-turned and stopped the amount at break-even, right? So this is kind of one example of what you'll see throughout the videos, but some of these trades, they do have a very high reward as well, which I think is very good also. But I do think that a lot of traders that would be interested in this is the ones that likes to say we've chopped the market, we've chopped NFP, the RCG way, right? Any case, let's continue because I'm starting to just dwell off now. Let's go to NAS 100 very quickly. Let's go all the way to the back. Now this is an example of a a very good risk reward trade. So we've got a 7% over here, but this trade had never reached that overall TP, but this for me is still very good. I think that's about 3% if you had to. No, it's about 2%, right? So I think that would have been good if, depending on whether you close the trade or not. But I want you guys to just focus on the strike rate, the communication in between, and decide whether or not this is something that you would like to put your money at as well. The next trade was a buy on the German 30 index, which we are going to go and take a look at very quickly. This was sent on the 5th of March, right? Now, I've put in these blue lines for you guys to easily navigate to see, the times and the dates for these signals. Here we can see the take profit had hit for 3%. There you can see DV blues. So well done. That was, how much was that? That was about 3%, right? The next trade was another buy on the NASDAQ, which was, here we go. This was a buy on the NASDAQ. This was in on March the 5th. Let's go. Okay, now this trade did not go too well. It went into some profit and then the stop loss had hit. And there you can see going well. And then there was no update thereafter, right? There was a sell on the German 30 index once again. And that was sent also on March the 6th at 9:31. And that is exactly where we are going to go at very quickly. 9:31 over here. And here we go. Am I correct? The March the 6th. Okay, cool. There we go at 9:31. Okay, let me just move that in for you guys to see the 9:30. There we go. So yeah, you can see once again, U-turned and then stopped. It got stopped out over there. Yes, it's floating deep again. You know what I said, like that, like this move is not that deep, but he falls part of that genre or that category of trading, right? 3:30 by Nasdaq, 2-3 minutes later, we are deep in the blues, close, like you understand. So they all fall into, like, then you get the TP1, TP2, TP3, TP4 type traders. Then you get the ones who trades, you know, they also, you have to put them in that category. And if I have to put him in that RCG category with Maps and Bandile, you know, he comes out on top, right? But we still have the other guy that we still need to do. I think he's also in the RCG way, right? There the man banked, what's that, 5,000, you know, 2,500 rand. But that is why I come back and I say that, why should you even trade your own money? You know, you don't need to make money if you're selling signals. You don't need to make money through trading when you're selling signals, because you make enough money with the, you know, the selling of the signals. Now this is where the signal starts to change, right? There you get a TP open and then an SL. Now there's no more TP, right? But in any case, Meltov, a very good trade once again. You know, Meltov seen results in the blue, in the blue screens. Again, like I always say, guys, I like to make fun throughout these videos, but I will never take away from the quality of the work, of the workmanship that these guys deliver, right? So let's continue very quickly, very quickly. Where are we now? March the 8th, we've got a buy on the Nasdaq. Let's go there quickly. Where are we now? Not a buy. Yes, we got a buy on the March the 8th. I did not plot it. How did I not plot that March on the 8th? Probably, I don't know how I missed this, guys. Sorry. This was a new signal, right? There you can see a buy NAS, buy gold, TP open, SL open, right? That was a new signal. And I always advise people, don't trade the news, but he said that they have chop the market. You can chop my money. I don't care. It's not fair. As I get you plenty. There we go. Next up was a trade on the German 30 index on March the 11th. That stop loss was in. Let's go there very quickly. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That March the 11th, that stop was hit. Then there was another sell. There you go. Sell German 30 again. That trade did go into some profits, right? It did U-turn to the upside. Once again, there was choppery blue screens. German 30 killed. German 30 killed. Account doubled. But there's really no point in posting blue screens if you are trading with a broker that you're promoting with the account management account that you are using. I would love for you guys to start posting some investors passwords in your free group for people that would like to sign up to your signals, right? Any case, killed it, TP'd. Okay, cool. I'm not sure where though, because if I don't know, he says TP hit 17630. There, that's where the TP was. But in any case, it's still a good trade overall. Any case, there we go. Buy the US 30. Is this the US? No, it's not the US 30. Let me just go to the US 30 for you guys very quickly. Here we go. Let's go. March the 11th. Where is it now? Yeah. Okay, now this trade went into some profits, right? In profits, there you can see a nice liquidity. We almost hit that TP, pulled back, then went up to the upside once again. Yeah, that's a deep blue send results. Now, I would assume that his method of saying close might potentially be seeing the results. I don't know, but there's no indication for most of these trades to be closed. You might have to close it when you're happy with profits. Now he says that I've got a young 43k funded for CPI topping the charts. Nyana dashboard looking clean. We topped the CPI today. And then this is where the problem comes. Why you should not trade fundamental information, right? Possible double spike. I don't know how you guys make these things up. And then goes. And then I don't understand how this works, right? Now I need you to just listen to me properly. He says he's got 43,000 rand to trade for CPI. He sends a loss of 20, you know, if you round this off, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, you know, this is a lot more than 40,000. And a lot of people is going to argue with me that, you know, this was a real account. And I'm saying that there's no way from a psychological perspective, these guys, they risk that type of money. Never. They will never do it. You know why they won't risk this type of money? Because then they will break even on their sales. They will never ever do it, really. Because this, if this was a live account, then he's made no money through selling these signals. And that's where the source of income is for these people. Well, most of them. Gold signal was killed, send the results. No, my friend. here's some blue screens, some blue, we got some blue, Dr. Royal, blue, some blue screens over there, and then on March the 13th, there was a sell on the German 30 index, which was on March the 13th, and that's where we're gonna go back to very quickly. Here we go. Okay, this trade also wasn't the best of trades, right? We've seen better. From this guy there, you can see the stop loss was hit. Let me take off this once. It's heavy and cold. It just doesn't work for me. Let's continue. Right, March the 13th, there was a buy on gold. Right. Okay, that's better. Okay, March the 13th, there was a buy on the gold. I got two golds here. I don't know why. Any case, here we go. Okay, beautiful trade. Once again, I'm not sure if that TP has hit, but it would probably say there. He did say, let's hold this trade. So that was another good trade, you know, based on my own opinion, once again. March the 14th, we're coming back to USD JPY. Again, we've got the one TP and one stop loss. Where are we now? There we go. So this trade also, I don't know, because, you know, yeah, we had a sell that was into profits. Then before we had the spike up and then that spike down. So I'm not sure if the stop loss had hit, because there's no update on the trade once again, right? So we're going to move over there. You can see the trade still running. But I'm referring to this double whammy over there, that double wick. Let's go to NASDAQ on the 14th. NASDAQ on the 14th. Here we go. Beautiful. TP hit 1.34%. Open positions 1 to 3, lot size 0.1, no risk, no reward. Again, you can't tell people what lot sizes to open because you don't know the account sizes. Right, top. A double buy on USD JPY, which was I think I might have March the 15th. No, man, I know I plotted that trade. There's no way. Oh, I'm looking at NASDAQ. Any case, let's go over the USD JPY. Yeah, I got still very early. Here we go. So this was two trades, right? Both at 1.81%. Both was TP'd. again, you know, that would give you about, you know, just over 3% for both positions. Deep in the blues, Ledwaba sell the German, sell the US 30. Let's go there once again. And I'm so, but you know, that is why I say, you know, if you made it to this far of the video, he falls in that RCG bracket, and out of them, he's, you know, like out of the RCG bracket way of trading, you know, we deep in the blues. Here we go. Right, this was a tight trade. This was a very tight trade. This trade had a very tight stop loss. If you observe that market move down, yeah, if you held this trade, you would have banked about 20%. But that means you would have need to calculate your risk, but also how tight the stop loss is. If you look at an example here from one of the people who send the results, you can see how far that, how close that SL is from the entry point, right? Again, very good trade, very good execution trade on there. There was a buy on US 30, boom boom, March 18th. Let's go. Yeah, boo, okay, sorry about that. Okay, unfortunately, you know, this didn't go too well, right? But there you can see deep blues. Now this is why I say why they fall in that category, because anything to these guys is considered a deep blues. Anything, even one pip, like deep in the blues, you know. So that is why I say that you can categorize them, okay? Because they all do the same stuff. They believe that a golf 7 is something you need in order to be successful in trading. Sell the Nasdaq, and look at the way he poses on his cars also. The same as, what's his name, Bandile does. You know the vibes that I had to go through in order to shoot you and make this video for you guys. Okay, here's another trade with a very tight stop. There we can see. Very nice. Choppity, chop. The tip it did not hit. So hopefully people was able to close. There you can see. Choppity, chop. Setup is going well. Deep in the blues. Then there was another sell on the Nasdaq. Here we go. That didn't go too well. I'm just going to speak a little. Let's just speed up the thing a little bit, right? GBP, JPY, March the 20th. There was a sell. No. Sure. Look, where am I? I didn't even plot it. That's just bad. Okay, cool. But in any case, I don't even know why though, because I'm not sure why. But yeah, so you guys can actually see there the trade has gone into some profits. But let me just do that. 9:49 March 20th. There. 9:49 March 20th. That was a sell. Okay. 192.534. There we go. And we had a TP there. TP and stop loss. Cool. So there we go. Okay. What a, about a 1% trade, top. We came close to hitting that TP there. Comment, like, see on the stories, close profits, 10:51. Then we got some, you can enter now as the event's starting because brokers in SA don't allow that. Okay, I'm not sure what that is for. Buy the Nasdaq. Here we go, buy the Nasdaq on the 20th. I'm not sure if that is a news trade as well. I think, yeah, no, I do think that this was a news trade. That is why I didn't, yeah, buy Nasdaq, TP open, SL open. And I think this is why I haven't plotted that trade, right? There you can see also buy gold. You can see the NAS 100 trade deep in the blues. There we go. Right. Some blue screens and some blue results, which is always good to see when, you know, any case. There was on March 22nd, which was this trade, that stop loss was hit over there. There was a sell on gold that took place on March the 22nd, which we are going to go and take a look. Hey, tap out your fan. There we go. Okay, that stop was triggered after a couple of times. March the 25th, there, set up your trading balance. LEDWABA is hosting a Zoom meeting. Then there was a trade on Euro USD, the Euro and the USD. March the 26th at 8:25. Okay, is it 25? Oh, sorry, 26. Okay, that trade went straight down. So zero drawdown from the bottom up. There you can see I just started going into profit, right? And that move there. So it's top. Buy the NASDAQ. There we go. What's that? The March 26th. March 26. So March 26. Yeah, it was this one. Right, TP open, SL open. So this is one of the reasons why you don't trade TP open, SL open. Because that could potentially just wipe away all the money that you have, right? Then there was a buy on the NASDAQ. That stop loss was triggered. The sell on the German 30 that we need to go and look at. Yeah, this one, I think it was, yeah. This one I don't understand because that's where the sell was placed at the time. To check the 10 there. Okay, that's where the price is. I think yeah was not but you can see that there's no updates. If you see no updates on a trade, you must know that things didn't go too well, right? So I believe that stop was triggered and this stop was triggered as well. There we go. That was the last one. So both these stops were triggered. I think yeah, that's it. So again, my conclusions, if you made it this far in the video, thank you so much for your watching, viewing pleasure. But other than that, you know, you guys let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Like I said many times in this video, I do think if you put him in that category of the RCG traders, you know, he's kind of the best for me out of that group. It doesn't necessarily mean that I agree with the way I would trade this way. No, I wouldn't trade the way. But in that category, yeah, he comes out a far away. Thank you for your time. And as always, cheers for years.